Hello, everyone. It's Friday, May 7th, 2021. Spring is in the air, and this is your Commonwealth Club Week in Review. Hear what you missed this week and what we've got lined up for you next week. I'm Sarah Catherine from the club's Climate One team, and I'll be your host for today's overview. Thanks for joining us. Yep, you heard that right. The club has a team that focuses specifically on climate-related stories. Climate One is a special project of the Commonwealth Club, and we've been leading the conversation on the climate emergency for over 10 years now. Through our weekly podcast, radio show, and live programs, we create opportunities for dialogue and inspire a more complete understanding of climate disruption. We're excited to be nominated for our first Webby Award for Best Limited Series in Science and Education. The club had a great week of programs, and there's a lot planned for next week as well. So let's get started. Tuesday at noon, Inforum presented Beyond the Screen, Race and Diversity in Hollywood. Our panel on race in Hollywood discussed industry-wide changes meant to increase representation for a new and diverse generation of creatives.
My theory has always been that there's a sort of moral and ethical component to this lack of representation, but there's also a business one, and that people are leaving a lot of money on the table because of these market perversions.
Tuesday at 3 p.m., it was Health and Medicine MLF co-chair Adria Breyer with Dr. Limon McHenry on the illusion of evidence-based medicine, distorted science in the age of big pharma.
And the problem, once again, is that the pharmaceutical industries, the ones that are doing the testing of their own products, are the ones that own the data.
Moving to Wednesday, May 5th at 12 noon, her husband John McCain lived by a code, country first. We are Republicans, yes, but Americans foremost. Join an inspirational program with Cindy McCain about her life and her husband's lasting legacy in a conversation with Cindy McCain.
We hear about guns, we hear about drugs, but we don't hear that much about human trafficking. And so I view my job as making sure that people hear me.
Wednesday evening at 6 p.m., the host of WNYC's Death, Sex, and Money podcast, Anna Sale, joined in forum to talk about the hard things.
People avoid the hard conversation thinking that that's going to keep them safe, but actually it just kicks the can down the road until the thing explodes.
On Thursday morning the 6th at 9:30, the complex relations between Iran and other states in the Near East is the topic of discussion in our Middle East member-led forum, Iran's Regional Dynamics in the Near East, a piecemeal approach.
Has Iran been less successful in expanding regional influence than assumed? Have opportunities to engage with Iran been squandered? Today we'll discuss in detail.
Thursday at 5 p.m., it was Michelle Miao with special guests Alicia Garza, Hala Hijazi, and John Osaki. How can communities preach beyond the choir and impact interactions in our daily lives? We find out in Walk the Walk and Talk the Talk, a deep dive into race relations.
We're going to explore changing the narratives about critical issues in the deep layers of race relations. How do we go beyond performative statements and build true solidarity within all of our communities?
And to wrap up the week, what stories do we tell ourselves to cope with a changing climate? Join Climate One host Greg Dalton with writers Nathaniel Rich and Meera Subramanian on how stories can help uncover the hopes and fears affecting people living closest to climate change. Now available on the Climate One weekly podcast and radio show.
Climate One conversations feature all aspects of the climate emergency, the individual and the systemic. I'm Greg Dalton.
Find all of our Climate One programs at climateone.org or wherever you download your pods. And inquire with your local public radio station to see if they carry the Climate One radio show. For next week, here's what's lined up starting next Tuesday, May 11th. At 9 a.m., food processing isn't listed on our Nutrition Facts food labels. The food labels tell us what's in the food, but Dr. Robert Lustig says that this is mostly irrelevant. What we really need to know is what's been done to the food. Hear more in Metabolical, the lure and the lies of processed food, nutrition, and modern medicine. Tuesday at 3 p.m., Wharton professor and Choiceology podcast host Katie Milkman offers a new strategy for breaking bad habits and making personal change, and will suggest new solutions for getting to where you want to be in The Science of Change. Moving to Wednesday, May 12th at noon, Stanford University President Mark Tessier Levine will be in conversation with past club board chair Mary Cranston on how the pandemic has catalyzed change in higher education in universities in the post-COVID world. Scandals and malpractice at companies like Theranos, WeWork, and Uber have raised questions about the quality of corporate governance. Wednesday at 3 p.m., economist Dambisa Moyo shares her insights on corporate ethics and improving corporate accountability. On Thursday the 13th at 3 p.m., it's Dr. Russell Poldrack on why our brains make habits stick. Thursday at 6 p.m., it's Conversations with Distinguished Citizens. Join Michael Krasny as he moderates this special program, recognizing two recipients of the club's Distinguished Citizen Award. The evening's honorees, John Pritzker and Dr. Matthew State, discuss their commitment to the improvement of mental health in the Bay Area and in the nation. And wrapping up the week, what can grassroots activists do that national organizations can't? Join Greg Dalton and his guests on Lessons from Grassroots Activists, our Climate One podcast, scheduled for release next Friday, May 14th. New episodes of the Climate One podcast are available every Friday, wherever you get your pods. Have a great weekend, everybody. Thanks again for your support and for listening. We'll have another week in review for you next Friday.